Volcanic eruptions have a big impact on the landforms of a region. The most violent rhyolitic eruptions can produce a feature called a caldera. Calderas are a very large depression caused by the collapse of the magma chamber of a rhyolitic volcano. Volcanic explosions in the magma chamber throw material clear off the vent. The unsupported walls of the vent and the top of the crater collapse into the chamber. Further magma forces its way to the surface and forms small cones on the floor of the caldera, which may later fill with water to form a lake. New Zealand's largest lake, Taupo, is actually an enormous caldera that has been partly filled by the lake. The present magma chamber is between 6 and 8 kilometres below the lake. Taupo is a rhyolitic supervolcano that has erupted numerous times. The most recent big eruption was 1800 years ago and was the world's most violent eruption in the last 5,000 years. The eruption plume reached 50 kilometres into the air, well into the stratosphere. All of New Zealand received at least 1 centimetre of ash, an example being these ash deposits in Farm Cove, Auckland, 272 kilometres away. Pyroclastic flows from Taupo spread up to 90 kilometres from the vent, forming the Rangipo Desert, which lies east of Ruapehu. Ash from this mighty eruption may have been the cause of red sunsets recorded by the Romans and Chinese at that time. 99% of the material erupted from Taupo is pumice and ash, which is clearly evident around the shoreline of the lake. Layered cliffs of light-coloured ignimbrite rock are also found around the lake. Mount Tauhara, at the northern end of the lake, is a relatively small lava dome formed from the 1% of magma that had lost enough gas to flow rather than explode. Other calderas in New Zealand include Lake Rotorua and Lyttelton Harbour in the South Island. Behind me here is Mount Tarawera. Mount Tarawera is an example of a rhyolite dome. Rhyolite domes form after a caldera has exhausted of all its gases. The result is that the magma oozes really slowly rather than quickly. So instead of flowing away from the crater like a normal lava flow, the lava instead piles up around the main vent. The result is a steep-sided dome, just like the one you see behind me now. There are many examples of rhyolite domes in the Bay of Plenty region, including Makoya Island and Mount Nongataha, which erupted within the Rotorua Caldera. Another rhyolite dome volcano is Mount Tarawera, which lies within the Okataina Caldera. The 1886 eruption of Mount Tarawera is New Zealand's largest in historic times. The volcano has three dome-shaped peaks, the highest being the Ruawahia Dome at 1,111 metres. These domes have been split down the middle by a series of fissures that run 17 kilometres northeast to southwest. The fissure includes the Waimangu Thermal Valley, which was created by the eruption. Tarawera is surrounded by a number of lakes created or altered by the 1886 eruption. Shield volcanoes are wide-based with gentle slopes. Their lava is runny and thin, which means that it can travel a long way before cooling and solidifying. Often, these eruptions are non-violent and can last for years. Rangitoto, which in Maori means bloody sky, is a volcanic shield volcano in Auckland's volcanic field. Rangitoto is New Zealand's youngest volcano and was formed by eruptions 600 to 700 years ago. Today, Rangitoto is 260 metres high and 5.5 kilometres wide. The summit is part of the scoria cone that encircles a crater. Today, you can visit the island and see lava fields and lava caves. Lava caves and tubes are formed when the surface of a lava flow cools and solidifies while the still molten interior flows through and drains away.
Strato volcanoes, also known as composite cones, are formed from alternate eruptions of ash and lava, which causes a steep-sided cone to be built of layers of ash and lava. New Zealand has several stratovolcanoes, such as Mount Ngarahoe behind me, Mount Ruapehu, Mount Taranaki, and White Island. Stratovolcanoes like Tongariro often have more than one vent. Tongariro is a massive complex of volcanic cones and craters formed by eruptions from at least 12 vents over thousands of years. This is caused by cooled lava becoming solid in the main vent. The magma escapes along fissures, which are small gaps, to form what we call a dyke. A dyke is a long wall of volcanic rock that cuts across other volcanic layers. Alternatively, a smaller parasite cone may form on the side of the main cone. Mount Tongariro has mineral springs and fumaroles. Fumaroles are steam vents. For example, on the other side of this mountain is a spring called Kiritahi Hot Springs. We also have behind me the Red Crater and the Tumari Crater. Some craters have filled with water to create the Blue Lake, which you can also see, and the Emerald Lakes. The Red and Tumari craters were previously active in the 1800s. The Tumari area has recently become active again in 2012.
Another stratovolcano on the North Island's west coast is Mount Taranaki. At 2,518 metres high, it is the second highest peak in the North Island. Taranaki, which last erupted in 1755, has a prominent parasite cone called Phantom's Peak on the south side. Mount Taranaki is also encircled by a ring plain, a circular plain built of materials washed by rivers or lahars from its cone. The rich volcanic soils of the ring plain are also popular with dairy farmers. Mount Ruapehu is a stratovolcano made of successive layers of andesite lava and ash deposits. At 2,797 metres, it is the largest active volcano in New Zealand. Ruapehu has several small glaciers at its summit, which are the only glaciers at present in the North Island. Ruapehu's active vent lies beneath the crater lake. The mountain is surrounded by a ring plain of volcanic material from lahars, landslides, and ash falls. A fumarole is a small geothermal vent from which volcanic gases and steam are emitted under pressure. The most spectacular types are geysers, which occur when steam or boiling water is thrown tens of meters into the air. For example, the Potu geyser in Rotorua. An explosion crater is a broad, low-reef volcanic crater formed by many shallow explosive eruptions and may be later filled with water. For example, in the Auckland volcanic field there are several explosion craters, including the Araki Basin and the Pamua Basin. Eruptions can result in the formation of low rings of pyroclastic rock called tuff. There are tuff rings around the craters of many of Auckland's volcanoes, such as Lake Pupuke.